Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that there are no days in the year in which righteous deeds are more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than these 10 days. And it's reported in another hadith that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to fast the first 9 days of Dhul Hijjah. Therefore, we're encouraged to fast throughout these days. One of the other things that we should remember is Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that there are four wordings that are more dearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, more beloved to Allah. That is subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, and la ilaha illallah. So these are adhkar and supplications that we can repeat in abundance. And the beautiful thing about these adhkar is that we don't require wudu for it. We don't have to be facing the qibla for it. And there's no specific timing of the day when it's prohibited, except of course when a person is relieving themselves. So we can recite these in abundance while we're walking, while we're driving, while we're sitting. Remember Allah Ta'ala as much as we can. So, فَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَذِكْرِكُمْ أَبَاءَكُمْ أَوْ أَشَدَّ ذِكْرًا, Allah says in the verses of Hajj in Surah Al-Baqarah, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like you used to remember your forefathers. He's speaking specifically to the pagans of Mecca, because they kept speaking about their forefathers and their greatness and their virtues. So Allah is saying, remember Allah more than them. أَوْ أَشَدَّ ذِكْرًا. So remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in abundance throughout these days. It's reported by Imam al-Bukhari rahmatullahi alayh that Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma and also Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu used to go to the marketplace and recite takbir aloud so that people are reminded of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during these days. Now, of course, we have to be mindful of our surroundings. I'm not going to tell you to go to the mall or to go to Walmart and scream Allahu Akbar, because in today's day and age, that could be taken as something else. However, we should definitely remind our household members, our family members, our beloved friends to increase takbir of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahu Akbar, throughout these days. We mentioned earlier that of course fasting throughout the first 9 days of Dhul Hijjah is glorious, but there is a special reward for the one who fasts on the day of Arafah itself. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, fasting on the day of Arafah, I have firm faith and conviction in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and trust in Him that it will expiate and remove the sins of the previous year and the following year. Therefore, we should strive to fast on the day of Arafah. And this is specifically for those who are not in Hajj. For the ones who are in Hajj, they don't fast the day of Arafah because they need their energy for their ibadah and their worship and their traveling from site to site. Of course, one thing that is encouraged during these days in abundance is dua and supplication, reaching out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and begging from Him. Because it's a glorious time of the year. So seek Allah Ta'ala's forgiveness, seek His mercy, reach out to Him, cry out in front of Him, pour your hearts out, flee to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what we're encouraged to do. فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ, flee to Allah, hold on to Him, seek refuge in Him. So these are things that we can inshallah try to do on the days of Dhul Hijjah.